Oh, first of all, how you feeling out there?
Yeah, yeah.
Oh, hold up a second.
I think we can do better than that.
I think we can do better. I want to hear them all the way from the back there.
Let's go.
I said, how we doing out there?
You know what, Case? I think this side could probably do better.
Well, I was about to tell you that. I think this side is where the noise is at today. I think we need a battle.
I think we need a battle.
So everyone on this side and everyone that just wants to be
on my team. You know what? I think I am the battle.
What?
Okay, yeah, carry on.
We're
okay,
cool. Speaking English.
Okay, here we go.
Speaking. All right, so this is what we're going to do on this side, okay? I'm going to say something, and I just want you to scream as loud, as proud, as big, as bright, as humongousness. Hey, Fano, you can't eat dinners with little lips. Here we go, Fano. If you came here to stand up for freedom, make some noise! That's already over.
You know what, King?
What's happening?
Now, that was the warm-up. We're about to do the real thing.
Okay.
Are we ready on this side? What? Hey, just give me a wave if you're ready.
I just saw a yawn.
Did you see a yawn?
I did.
Yeah, because they yawned after that. Okay, here we go. Are you ready? When I say make some noise, you're going to make some noise from here. No, I'm going to say this. Get your lips ready.
Uh-oh.
Get your cheeks ready. Get your eyes ready. Get your eyebrows ready. Get your hair ready. Get everything ready. Are you ready? Why don't you make some noise? Yeah, 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 yeah. Yeah. Make some noise. Make some noise. Everybody, make some noise.
Now, before we get this amazing day underway, I just want to say, are amazing. Guess what? No matter what has come our way over the last couple of days, today is going to be a beautiful day celebrating families. I want to acknowledge all of the families that have come along today. If you've got your tamariki here, your children, put your hands up right now. Because you know what? We were painted as a violent mob, but we are here peacefully. Every time we've gathered peacefully.
Let's go.
Every time we've gathered, passion. But you know what? You don't bring Nana, Koro, Grandma, Granddad, your babies, you don't bring them to a violent protest.
That's right, that's right.
So to all of the media that are here today, stop lying.
Hey, can I just say, to all the media, stop it.
Cut it out.
Stop it.
You know, it's like when you get that, you cut it out.
Cut it out.
Come on, man.
Yeah, but we are.
Oh. Some of the coolest dudes you'll ever meet.
Hey, I am. You are.
Oh, right.
Me and you together.
Oh my.
We are LL Cool J.
Okay. I like that.
Okay. No, okay.
We'll just half the crowd.
Yeah. Who's that? Don't worry about it.
Awesome.
You don't need to worry about it.
So you know what, family? Today, I just want to encourage you. We're going to be doing something so powerful today that it doesn't matter what was said. It doesn't matter what continues to be painted as the picture. When we stand peacefully, when we stand with a real solid passion in our hearts for the freedom, for the rights of all good New Zealanders, for our country to get back this nation that we love so dearly, it doesn't matter what the painter is, that the picture is that's painted, we will have the victory if you believe that. Why don't you make some noise?
Awesome.
You know, for me, I've got my sons here, I've got my nephews here, I've got my whānau and my family here.
Yep.
And I know you've got your kids and your mokopunas here. Yep. Oh, pardon. But you have got your kids here.
Yes. Yep, I've got my two daughters, my wife, and my beautiful one-year-old son. And you wouldn't do that if you felt like things were going to get violent. So, you know, to all of you guys that have travelled, if you've come from the South Island, why don't you make some noise?
Yeah.
If you've come from Kaitaia, why don't you make some noise? If you've come from Auckland, why don't you make some noise? Oh, if you've come from Tauranga, why don't you make some noise?
If you've come from Hamilton, make some noise.
If you've come from Gisborne, make some noise.
If you've come from Pakarua, make some noise.
Yeah. If you've come from Rotorua, make some noise.
If you've come from here, wherever you've come from, make some noise.
And that's the power of what we stand in right here today. All different people from all different walks of life. We've got farmers, we've got nurses, teachers, we've got doctors, youth workers, social workers, firemen. We've got all walks of life coming together today. And the beautiful thing is
we're all Kiwis.
We're all Kiwis.
New Zealanders, we love New Zealand. Hey, wait, just real quick, because all our family are here, just turn to three or four people next to you, if they're not your family, and just give them a high five and say, hey, welcome. Welcome today.
Yeah.
Because that's what it's all about, families.
Look at this. Man, it's a beautiful day today to celebrate freedom, I'll tell you that. Now, come on now.
Then we ended up in Auckland, and so we, some of the whānau, they met us there. We had a bit of a feed, and, we just gathered together, had some fun. We got ready, prepared, and then we made our way onto the motorway. You know what? It's all about safety, because that's what we do. Yep. We want to make sure that we do things safe and we do things right. So we made our way onto the motorway, and then we ended up going to Hamilton. Wow. Yeah, yeah. Is there anyone from Hamilton? Yeah, up in here. Yes, and we made our way to Hamilton, and then bang. Woo! What a journey. But you know what? Throughout the whole journey, there were so many freedom fighters.
Yeah.
So many freedom fighters waving their flag. If you got a flag, why don't you just wave that up in the air?
Oh.
Let's go.
Check them out.
Now, on that whole journey, we had thousands and thousands of freedom fighters on the side of the road who were waving their flag, and then they joined us. And it's so awesome. So if you were a part, and you were waving those flags on the side of the road, and you're here today, why don't you make some noise up in here? Awesome.
Amazing. And that's what it's all about. You know, there've been a lot of things painted as there's a lot of people against what we're doing, but you know what? The more we get out there, the more we realize, actually, a lot of people believe the same things that we do. And because of your courage, other people are too finding their courage and starting to join us. So, hey, why don't you put your hands together for each other? Why don't you put your hands together for your neighbor? Oh, you guys are amazing.
And we talk about courage.
Let's go.
And it started with a man, and it started with
indeed.
Some boldness and courage.
Woo!
Why don't you just break that down for us?
So I remember the beginning of the Freedom and Rights Coalition.
Come
on! I remember how it all started.
Wait. Tell me about it.
Oh, do I?
Once upon a time. Do you want to take your jacket off?
Oh, no.
Leave it on.
It's a little bit choked.
Leave it on.
It's a little bit choked. But we started off at the Auckland Domain. And there were about, how many people do you think were there at that first one?
Thousands.
Wow. And you know, it didn't start off with the humongous crowd that we thought, but we gathered. We came together. And then guess what? It wasn't too long after that we came together again, the crowd doubled. We're like, actually, there's something going on here. Because we knew something wasn't right. We knew we needed to make sure that we had a place where people could come and gather that felt
and
like
we
they
still
were
know something's not right.
That's right.
But carry on.
And then guess what? We came together again a few weeks later, and the crowd doubled again. We did it one more time, and the crowd reached over 10,000 people. That is what courage does. It started with one man, and I want to make a massive shout out to him. It's Brian Tamaki's here. Hey, let's put our hands together. You know what? I was given a program, okay? And this is how I went. I turned up
you know
to
what?
Event. I was given a program.
Only you were given the program.
Let's not go too far into detail.
Sorry.
Anyway, I was given a program. And there were four names on that program that were supposed to speak that day. Guess what?
Hey, did you say four?
There were
That's
four.
Like tahi roa toru wha.
Thanks for that.
Okay, thank you.
Great stuff.
Māori, I'm just trying to break it down.
Wow.
Okay,
so
cool.
There were four people that were meant to speak. Only one man was there to take the microphone. And that was Brian Tamaki. You know what? To all the media outlets that are here today,
come on.
You ain't been successful in shutting down a man who's always done his best to stand for this country.
Listen to the media.
Guess what? You ain't done did it. We're still winning.
And we're still
Let's go, baby. Make some noise up in here.
Let's go.
Woo! Sorry.
Hey,
we're going to be celebrating. We're going to be making some noise. But this has been an interesting journey. And you know what? Let's talk about some of the coincidences.
Oh, did you say coins?
There were some coincidences. So there was a ferry shut down for 24 hours.
What a coincidence.
Because they wanted to look at their ventilation. It might have been a coincidence. The next coincidence that took place, whānau, was the trains aren't running today from 9 a.m. to 10 a.m.
What a coincidence.
Was not
hey, when it's time to say what a coincidence, we need your help.
Let's
okay, carry on.
The next coincidence was exactly the time you guys were in the convoy arriving at a specific destination.
Yep.
BP were shutting down for a couple of hours.
What a coincidence!
And it doesn't stop there.
Why not? Why doesn't it stop? Make it stop!
My goodness. Father, some of our family that have had to drive through the night because they ain't going to quit, had to drive through the night because their tickets were all of my sudden.
Well, all of my what?
On them. All of my sudden. Yes.
Okay.
And I'm sticking by it. Their flight tickets were all of my sudden cancelled on them.
What a coincidence.
But you know what, family? It doesn't matter what coincidence is.
It doesn't matter.
It doesn't matter what coincidence is. Because if you're truly a freedom fighter,
come on,
you're going to make sure that you're here. You're going to make sure that I told you on the live streams we're going to be partying today.
Yeah.
We got a lot to celebrate.
You need to stop taking these. But we'll carry on.
Now, okay. We've got an amazing program, and I'm just going to pull out my phone.
Yeah, well, better you, because I haven't got mine.
And we're going to introduce the first of our speakers, because we want to make sure that throughout this journey, we're being kept up to date with some of the things that have been going on. So this man is a member of the NZDSOS. Been a doctor for 37 years. That's 37 years, that's older than I am.
Whoa.
Why are you laughing? Okay. But certainly not able to work as a doctor, so speaks today as a concerned private citizen. Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome to the stage, 37 years in his field, Matt Shelton!
Everybody. So time you heard from somebody, the older generation, just at the beginning we thought we'd get that out of the way, but I'm going to be reading you most of your speech from somebody even older than myself. Okay, sorry. So this last week has been the 75th anniversary of the Nuremberg Declaration. Now, in NZDSOS we continue to fight for human rights, and against medical tyranny. Okay, is that any better? Okay, I'm in direction. So I want to read you some excerpts from a speech by an 84-year-old concentration camp survivor called Vera Shiraz. And at 3.5 years old, she and her family were carted off to a concentration camp. She was from Romania, where her father died, and she was separated from her mother for 4 years. So she and a group of others have walked the walk and have talked the talk ever since. And she gave a speech last week that is very powerful, and I want to read some extracts. So the Nuremberg Declaration came out of the Nazi war trials following the Second World War, and it particularly spoke to the atrocities of genocide, the Holocaust, and medical experimentation. So she says, I came to Nuremberg to provide historical context to the current global threat confronting our civilization. These past 2.5 years have been especially stressful as painful memories were rekindled. The Holocaust serves as the archetypal symbol of unmitigated evil. But the Holocaust did not begin in the gas chambers of Auschwitz and Treblinka. It was preceded by 9 years of incremental restrictions on personal freedom and the suspension of legal rights and civil rights. The stage was set by fear-mongering and hate-mongering propaganda. A series of humiliating and discriminatory government edicts demonized Jews as spreaders of disease. We were compared to lice. Medicine was perverted from its healing mission and was weaponized. First, it was to control reproduction through forced sterilization. Then it was to eliminate those deemed to be subhuman. Untermenschen is the German word. The first victims of medical murder were 1,000 disabled infants and toddlers. This murderous operation was expanded to an estimated 10,000 children up to age 17. The next victims were the mentally ill. They were followed by the elderly in nursing homes. All of these human beings were condemned as worthless eaters. So where have we heard that recently? The objective of the Nazi final solution was to annihilate the entire 11 million Jewish population of Europe as quickly and efficiently as possible. The purpose of Holocaust memorials is to warn and inform future generations about how an enlightened, civilized society can be transformed into a genocidal universe ruled by absolute moral depravity. If we are to avert another Holocaust, we must identify ominous current parallels before they poison the fabric of society. Since the Nazi era, the study of history in most of the humanities, including philosophy, religion, and ethics, have been overshadowed by an emphasis on utilitarian science and technology. As a result, few people recognize foreboding similarities between current policies and those under the Nazi regime. By declaring a state of emergency in 1933 and in 2020, constitutionally protected rights were swept aside. Repressive, discriminatory decrees followed. In 1933, the primary target for discrimination were Jews. Today, the target seems to be people who refuse to be injected with experimental, genetically engineered vaccines. Then and now, government dictates were crafted to eliminate segments of the population. In 2020, overseas government dictates forbade hospitals from treating the elderly in nursing homes. Then and now, government dictates were crafted, FDA-approved medications by government decree were forbidden to doctors, and government-dictated protocols continue to kill in some countries. The media was silent, as it is now. The media broadcasts a single government-dictated narrative, just as it had under the Nazis. Strict censorship silences opposing views. In Nazi Germany, few people objected. Those who did were imprisoned. Today, doctors and scientists who challenge the approved narrative are maligned, and their reputations are trashed. They risk losing their licenses to practice, as well as having their homes and workplace raided by police teams. The moral significance of the Nuremberg Code must not be overstated. It is the most authoritative, internationally recognized document in the history of medical ethics. This landmark document was formulated in response to the evidence of medical atrocities committed by Nazi physicians and scientists. The code sets forth moral boundaries for research involving human beings. The Nuremberg Code rejects the ideology of eugenics and unequivocally asserts the primacy and dignity of the individual human being, as opposed to the greater good of society. The Code defined foundational universal moral and legal standards, affirming fundamental human rights. These human rights apply to every human being. The Code sets limits on the parameters of permissible medical experiments. Equally important, it holds doctors and research investigators personally responsible to ensure the human subject's safety and ensure that the person freely gave his voluntary consent, fully informed. The standards of the Nuremberg Code are incorporated in the International Criminal Code. They are legally applicable in peacetime and in war. The objective of the Nuremberg Code is to ensure that medicine never again deviates from the precautionary ethical principle: first, do no harm. The Code served as blueprint for subsequent national and international codes of human rights to ensure that the human rights and dignity are upheld. To ensure that medical doctors never again engage in morally abhorrent experiments. Like the Ten Commandments, not a word of the code may ever be changed. The first of the ten ethical principles lays down the foremost ethical requirement, which is spelled out in great detail. The voluntary consent of the human subject is absolutely essential. And it ends by saying the duty and responsibility for ascertaining the quality of the consent rests upon each individual who initiates, directs, or engages in the experiment. It is a personal duty and responsibility which may not be delegated to another with impunity. Those who declare that Holocaust analogies are off limits are betraying the victims of the Holocaust by denying its relevance. The Nuremberg Code has served as the foundation for ethical clinical research since its publication 75 years ago. The COVID pandemic is being exploited as an opportunity to overturn the moral and legal parameters laid down by the Nuremberg Code. It is our defense against abusive experimentation. This time, there will be no rescuers. Unless all of us resist, never again is now. Vera Sharav, Holocaust survivor. So I just want to finish by saying there is nothing especially abhorrent about the German people or the Japanese people. In war, all nations will act with depravity. The point is, we are peaceful. And we need to change this by peaceful means if we possibly can. So thank you very much for your time, and I hope you have a fantastic day.
Some questions if we can. So the next song. So the next song is our anthem. We all know the song. Everyone sing along.
Keep on keeping on. All right, family, come on, make some noise! All right, we are almost there, we are almost there. But I brought up some fam from Australia, Auckland, the North, all over the country to rip some voices. What we're going to do right now, we're going to get our atmosphere set and prime for once we start to hit off in March. So we got that track ready, DJ. Now, are you ready, family? Make some noise!
Oh, excuse me.
Here we go, here we go.
Let's go.
Everybody, I want to raise their hands up right now. Hey, let's go, freedom family. Let's go.
I'm taking it my back like this. Cooking place like this. Never beat the game up to the best. First fight where we fight. The over will be right. You gotta know what they continue to take right. We all smoke. They all smoke like a wind turkey. Buzz good when the runners get the wind dirty. And I ain't smoking weed. Tell me where the bars be. Almost like I couldn't stand straight. When the stars will see. That's your worry. Muscle in me body. Dance away from the corner. Double from the focus. We fight to stand 10 coverage more. Face it back. Now we have to work it all. Just to bring it back. Not just politicians. Face it aside. Bring it back. You do the math the way they mark it the back. Sick of it. Stop in the chamber before the key.
Freestyle while I freestyle, man, we're gonna hit the plane. We're gonna fuck from DI to Mandarin to Kelson. We gentrifying every block that shelter my people up in the street hustling. Subliminal discrimination is getting kind of blatant. And now I think the government is impatient. They're trying to shut down community collaborative because we're living outside of their economic narrative. But it's imperative that we stay relevant. Power to the people, we're keeping it in our element. Top pay the landlord in time, tax on incline. Wait for the toll in the wind's line. Don't get me started on inflation. We got a few shortages coming up as we're living in disassimilation. Children living hard, children living wrong. Children paying the prices for the mess that we start. Children living hard, children living wrong. Children paying the prices for the mess that we start.
All rise, courts in session to send your facing charges of time neglection. Breach of protection, mandated force, lethal injection. And should I say unforced, home detention. Be here now to make a difference. Should I mention unlawful arrest for the right to protest? It's protest, put your hands in the air. Bang with your chest and tell them that we here. Put your hands in the air, say it with your chest. Labor gotta go with the rest. Put your hands in the air, say it with your chest. Labor gotta go with the rest. Put your hands in the air, say it with your chest. Labor gotta go with the rest.
Hello! We finally made it! Yay! Big clap for you. Big cheer for you. It's so wonderful to just be here today in Wellington with the 500 people that are here today. I would say over 5,000 people here today. So awesome. Never mind the false prophets. They love to down everything that's positive. But you know what? I just want to say what a privilege it is to stand and walk amongst so many beautiful people. And thank you for the encouragement, the support that you have given us over this time. Sadly, the last three protests in Wellington, we're still on bail, but we were not allowed to be anywhere near any protest, talk about protests or anything. But today we're here, and we're here because you matter. And I just want to say a few quick things. We are the parents of three adult children, 10 grandchildren, and 3 great-grandchildren. They matter to us, and we do not want them to fight the fights that we are able to fight for today. We want them to know, as they look through the corridors of time, that people stood with their granddad, their great-granddad, their father, with a whole lot of other beautiful, strong kiwis who wanted to make a difference. And together, we are making a difference. You need to salute yourself every day for having the courage to stand the way that you have been standing, for taking the persecution that you have been getting, for the way you've been hit by the trolls on your Facebook pages, and sometimes it's made some of you afraid to make comments. Continue to stand, New Zealand. Be strong.
Check, check, yeah, there we go. Now, family, it has come to that.